Welcome, my legion, to Banjo-Tooie. Or should I say, welcome back.
Come on, come go up.
Yes, the spell in this particular area is an enlarging spell. You can make your jokes in the comments if you really, really must.
Come on, yo. Oh, yo.
Okay, enlarging Wamba's wigwam makes me have a couple of questions, but none of them are suitable for an E-rated game, so I'm just going to put those off. But it makes me wonder why there's no giant S artwork of Wamba, if you catch my meaning. Grandkids, don't look that up. Just do me the favor and don't. Because I'm partly terrified of what you'll find. Alright, now, since we've enlarged Wamba's wigwam, let's go back over there and take another dip in her pool. Her giant, oversized pool. Since everything inside of Wamba's wigwam also grew, including Wamba. I like how it's just the standard banjo voice. That doesn't make any sense whatsoever. Now, as the daddy T-Rex, we are basically invincible. We are also terrifying every other living thing around us. And if we walk into them, they die. Which I would love to show off there, but yeah, I can't. And this may be the other reason that the baby T-Rex doesn't have a breath meter on it, because the adult T-Rex, the daddy one, doesn't really go underwater that far. I'm not even sure why. Yeah, who's not scary now? I'm terrifying. I'm a T-Rex. I'm a giant carnivorous monster. You wanna mess with me? You really wanna mess with me? Just remember that I'm the bear and bird that are walking around here. And, dips. I didn't actually mean to hurt him, like, at all. Okay. Careful. 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 This kind of destroys that whole power trip I was on. And now, let's go ahead and hit this switch, which we can only do as the giant T-Rex. Which exposes a Jinjo, which we have 35 seconds to get to, which is a very generous amount of time, to be completely honest. quickly transform back into Banjo-Kazooie and hightail it to that Jinjo. Now you may be wondering, won't you be cutting it close? And the answer to that is, not really. I mean, we basically have over 10 seconds to get in and out of this place. And since we caught the Jinjo, the timer's not even gonna bother going down, so what's the big deal? I forgot about that. I'll explain later, and we'll come back to this spot in a minute. It would have been smarter to go grab Bumbo after that. Oh well. Anyway, let's see, what else do we have to do in this world? There's the family. I can't even remember what species of dinosaur they are, but let's go ahead and pop into them. See exactly how these guys are holding up. And yet another possessed beehive. Oh, hey, look, a drillable rock. And a spring pad? I feel like these don't get used enough in this game, which is odd because they totally get used at least once in every stage, if I remember correctly. Which is more than Banjo-Kazooie, if I, again, remember correctly. And there, I believe, is the last empty honeycomb, maybe? I think it is. And there's, of course, another drillable rock right over here, which you do want to crack open. And now, let's go talk to the, sad mother figure. Self-referential humor of this game makes me smile sometimes. Alright, let's see. Before we do anything else, let's go ahead and stuff this guy into our backpack. How anything fits in there like that, I will never know. And, now we're going to talk about the unfortunate implications here. You see, when Banjo has an empty pack, quote-unquote, he uses it as a weapon. He swings it around. Now we have someone inside of there, and we're still swinging it around like a weapon. This is where Banjo's 1-2 punch from the first game probably should be put into effect. But of course, that's not going to happen, because that would make way too much sense. But if we want to get this sick one fixed, we're going to have to go take him somewhere else, since Mumbo only does enlarging magic here. So let's go ahead and call Chuffy. Chuffy. And by a complete accident, we have solved one of this lady's problems. I honestly had completely forgotten we had put that child on this train. But now we have another one on this train, and we'll be taking her to the Isle of Hags as soon as possible. Sorry about that. Now, as for Kazooie, let's see. I don't think there's anything else we can do with Kazooie for now, so we might as well head her over to the train station. Meet up with Banjo and whatnot. Especially since, if I remember the order of events correctly, we're going to need both of them for this next area. No, Banjo, no! Stay away! I do not need your magic right now. Leave me be and never return! But I'll see you guys next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie.